Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I probably look like the last video. That's because I'm filming two in one day. I've been sick, so I'm just kind of trying to catch up on things I need to do. I actually have three more mascaras that were in the bottom of that thing. The next one is the Maybelline Rocket. I love this mascara. I definitely will repurchase it. It's like a rubber bristled mascara. It's a great mascara. It, again, never disappoints, has never let me down. The next one is the CoverGirl Clump Crusher. And again, it's just a rubbery bristle. You can actually see the green on the bristles. So I'm guessing that means, hello, it's gone. But again, love this mascara. I'm kind of a mascara junkie, so I kind of like to experiment with different mascaras and things of that nature. But yeah, I really love the three that I talked about, and then this one I love as well. I love this bigger side for your upper lashes. I love this side more than I think I love for your bottom lashes. This other side right here, it's a two-in-one mascara, and this one's like a very tiny little wand. I don't know. I like this mascara a lot. I definitely do. And I have nothing to say bad about any of the mascaras. I would definitely repurchase all of them again. Next is the Olay Age Defying Anti-Wrinkle Day Cream and Serum. So this claims to be a day cream and a serum. I can say that, oh, and it comes with a pump. So that is always amazing because you don't want to, I don't know, pumps are just better. They're always better. So with this, I can definitely say that, to me, in my opinion, it holds up to the claims. It is a serum and it is a cream. It hydrates my skin. It makes my skin feel hydrated. It doesn't make it feel dry and like really tight. It doesn't do that. I can literally go with this in the daytime. I can put it on in the morning and I can go out throughout my whole day and I don't have the need to put on an extra cream, as where the L'Oreal one, I definitely have to put on a cream after because it doesn't give the hydration of a moisturizer. It just does the serum, which it doesn't claim to be a moisturizer. So this one I really do love. I love it for the morning time. It's nice, it's light, and that's that. This is the Maybelline Define a Brow. And this, I'm kind of upset because this didn't last very long, and I don't know. This is kind of a weird product to me. First of all, it comes with this little brush right here, which isn't bad, but it's just not the kind of brush I would personally use for my eyebrows. So I didn't really get a lot of use out of that little brush. Then it's supposed to be this nice brown color, but I think I have a little bit left. When it's on, I mean, it's brown, but it has like a reddish tint or something to it. Maybe it's just my skin, I'm not sure, but when this is on my brows, see how my brows look nice and brown and they match my face? When I'm using this, and this is the light brown, so it's not like it's dark brown or anything crazy. When I use this on my face, my brows look very strange, almost like this color right here. Like it has a strange reddish tint to it, so if I'm in a pinch, I would probably repurchase it, but it's definitely not my first choice. That's for sure. I have these two hairsprays here for you, and this one is Redken. It's a little sample that I've had literally forever, and it's the 12 hold, and then I have a big size of the 23 hold. So Redken has to be hands down my favorite hairspray ever. If you want your hair to still be touchable and everything like that, I would definitely recommend getting a Redken hair spray. Obviously, they have this, they have travel sizes, so if you're not sure about it, just get a travel size and see how you like it. But I've went through two of these, and I love them. I have the Big Sexy hairspray, and I have like three or four of them, and they're not even halfway done yet because they make my hair feel very crispy, and I don't like that. I like my hair to hold the curl, but I like it to be touchable. So definitely loving these here Redken sprays. Next, I have a shampoo And I swear we're almost done. I only have two things left in there. This is a Redken All Soft Shampoo. It claims to pretty much repair your hair and make it soft. It's just another shampoo, I guess. It does make my hair a little bit softer, but it's nothing like, oh my god, my hair is so beautiful. It's nothing crazy. It's just kind of, in my opinion, it's just kind of an average shampoo. It's not something that I would run out and, oh my gosh, go buy now. But if you do have damaged hair, it might help. I guess it did make my hair a little bit softer, but it just, it's, I don't know. It says softness for dry and brittle hair. I don't know if it totally held up to those claims, but, you know, whatevs. Oh, and I have this just acetone bottle. I threw that in there because that's what I use to take my nail polish off. Excuse my nails, they are so, so bad. I mean, I've been sick, guys. I'm really sorry. But this is just 100% pure acetone. This is what I use to take off any polish. I know that it's harsh on your skin and your everything, but it gets the job done, and I don't like to sit there for hours and hours and hours with a nail polish remover. I just whip this out and go. So yes, I will repurchase it. Yes, I have. The next is this Tresemme Extra Firm Control Hairspray, I guess. All day humidity resistant, and it's a level 4 hold. So again, this one's okay. I really just got it because I was in a wedding and I wanted my hair to stay put, and I wanted to, just in case it didn't, I wanted to have something to touch it up with. Blah, gosh. Okay. I just wanted to have a hairspray on hand in my purse to touch up with, and this was the only one that I could find that was a travel size. So I went ahead and picked it up, and I mean, it's not a bad hairspray. It's definitely good. The smell is not that great. The Redken smells amazing. But, I mean, this one's just kind of an average hairspray. It's not amazing. It's not bad. It's just kind of average. This is the last thing in the box. This is the last thing, and then we are done, and I'm so happy because my voice is going away. Okay. This is the Anti-Breakage Keratin Oil Conditioner by Organics. I have to tell you how much I love Organics, first of all. Oh, it smells so good. Their brand is amazing. I use their hair oil all the time, and it just kind of gives this shine to my hair, and I just love it. So, definitely a big fan of Organics in general. This one is, what is the smell? It says, and so it's a keratin oil, it has argan oil in it, and it is the conditioner. It looks like this. It's absolutely amazing. I have nothing bad to say about this. It gets your hair nice and soft. I do notice a difference after using this. It's definitely empty. I do notice a big difference after using this. It just makes my hair feel nice and soft, and I have a few other products from the shampoo conditioner line. I noticed that if I use it too much, like if I use it every time I wash my hair, it seems like my hair gets really weighed down and looks really oily. So I can't use this every time I wash my hair, which is only like twice a week, maybe three times a week. So I can't use this every time I wash my hair, but I do use it probably every other time. And I have the cherry blossom and can't remember, but something else in my shower right now, and I just love them. So that is all the products that I used up in this time around. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I just kind of wanted to quickly mention on my lips is one of these Maybelline elixirs or whatever they're called. They just look like this. They're so cute, and then they look like a little lipstick in there. Super cute. This one is in Petal Plush. I mixed it with that really dark, deep, beautiful purple one. And if you guys want to see a swatch video on these, let me know. On the lips, I have 4 of them. And I have to say that I absolutely love them. This one's just the most wearable. So I keep this one in my purse all the time, and I really love it. So if you guys want to see a video on that, then let me know in the comments. And I think that's it. If you are feeling sick, I really pray that you get better because this is no fun and no joke. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Mwah!